Motion.
Motion, please.
Like, will anyone let me complete what I said?
Neither it is recording.
So I invite the Prime Minister to come up and open the case from side proposition. And please repeat the motion for the benefit of the House. Huh.
I hope so.
All on record.
See, the motion before the House is that this was supposed to be mandatory refugee quota, right? And we are going to propose it, and how we are going to prove this, or how we are going to tell you that we, this House being France, is going to support the mandatory refugee quota is because first of all we tell you that what this country, France, means to the entire world, right? Secondly, we will tell you that what kind of condition or what kind of atrocities France has gone through. Thirdly, we will tell you that what does this mandatory quota effectively mean, right? Or what does it effectively signify, or what does it effectively indicate to the entire world? And fourth, we will tell you that how, what do we actually achieve, or what do we want to achieve after going through what we have actually gone through, right? What do we want, or what do we want, or what kind of steps do we want to take? And fourthly, we will tell you what. Between these arguments, we will tell you that how the mandatory quota or how implementing the mandatory quota is somehow or exactly similar to what we want to achieve, and not implementing the mandatory quota is actually against that or against what we want to achieve. Right? So, first, we will tell you that what kind of country France is, right? France is an exhibition of culture, right? France is one of the societies that can actually be proud of calling itself. Variety are heterogeneous, right? There are number of societies within the European Union that are completely homogeneous, that do not allow multiple ideologies, that do not allow multiple classes, multiple cultures, the number of Eastern European countries. But France is one country that boasts of this kind of multicultural diversity. France is one country that boasts of this kind of heterogeneous society. France is one such country which identifies itself as a country which is tolerant to all these religions. France is one such country which is identified across the world that this is one country that agrees with philosophy. This is a country that is ready to accept philosophy, that is ready to accept religion, that is or that is tolerant enough to accept multi variety or you get the point.
Sir?
Secondly, we tell you that what kind of things France has gone through, right? France went through this Paris bombing, right? And what actually came out was the fact that across these bombings or in the suicide attacks or whatever happened, the number of people that were involved in the plotting of this event, there was one such person who turned out to be eventually a refugee, right? So, and also being said that the others were not refugees. I think that means. So, this one person turned out to be a refugee, and based upon that, what would be one such.
Do you believe US to be a country that is this multicultural exhibitionist?
So, next point being that this move of ours or what this mandatory quota basically signifies is one such thing that this mandatory quota indicates that this is sympathy of France or the European Union itself towards these Syrian refugees, right? This is France taking up, not shaking away from its responsibility, France taking up its responsibility as a responsible country, as a humanitarian country on humanitarian grounds. As this signifies France not differentiating Islam people or Syrians in itself. This signifies France differentiating the Syrian people from the terrorists, right? This completely signifies that France does not label every single Islam person or every single Syrian person as a terrorist, and which is completely what this mandatory quota signifies, right? And secondly, what this mandatory quota signifies is that once France takes this up, the mandatory quota is for the entire EU, right? So France is willing to take the responsibility for the entire European Union, that we as Western developed countries, we as developed countries have this responsibility to take upon us, that we want to see the Syrian citizens and we do not want to shake away from the responsibility of saving of this humanitarian responsibility of these people actually running away from their home, these people actually getting out there, getting killed, and we do not want to wage a war against the philosophy itself, against the philosophy of Islam itself, because we are not against Islamist people in general, right? Because what happens when we impose this mandatory quota is what happens is that we are not okay with you Syrians landing on our land, right? We are not okay, and why is that? Because you guys bombed us, right? So this not only a direct refusal of mandatory quota, but the refusal of mandatory quota post the Paris bombings directly places them at the heart of the bombings, right? So this is what we take is that if France goes out today and imposes this does not impose this mandatory quota or change away from his responsibility, France directly blames the Syrian refugees or the entire Islam for this Paris bombings and not this what this is going to lead to, right? So first of all, we told you about what France really wanted. Next, we tell you that what France really wants from what kind of steps France wants to take.
So, because
the French people will be okay with this. Yes, sir, French people will be okay with this because French people is this entire society which includes Muslims, right? And next, we are going to tell you how this move of yours is going to destroy the entire society France is so proud of. So what we want to achieve are two cases, two things, right? One, we want to make sure we should put another. So what we want to achieve is basically two things, right? One, we want to make sure that France does not lose its society. We want to make sure that France does not lose its society. The entire society of France does not get destroyed, because what's going to happen now? The second thing that we want to make sure is that we are able to dilute the ISIS. We are able to dilute ISIS, the direct perpetrators of these bombings, right? So what we think about ISIS are that these are these radical people who are not open to these ideologies, not open to thinking, and this radical Islam group that all they want is a single caliphate. And how do these people gain numbers, right? They are able to deceive people into thinking that these entire Western liberal countries are against you, right? And this is how they gain numbers and this is how they gain strength. So what's going to happen is that every single step that France takes against the entire philosophy of Islam is supporting ISIS in itself and not diluting it and not breaking it and not defeating it, and which is completely antithetical to what France wants right now, right? What we want right now is to take steps against ISIS, is to dilute ISIS, and in the long run defeat ISIS if possible, right? And this is something that we are telling you that this is completely going to break down and be against all of our motives if we go out and wage a war against this entire society, because all this is going to do is give the ISIS people an example to tell you this, yes, these people do not care about you, right? And these are not tolerant towards your beliefs, and hence they are antithetical to your existence, which is what our entire philosophy is, right? And this is what the ISIS people will say. So, and hence they will gain numbers, and hence they will gain strength, and hence they will do more bombings. And today, France, tomorrow, Japan, and entire EU will suffer, and entire world will suffer, right? This is something we are completely against. Second thing that we have a problem with is the breakdown of society that's going to happen today, right? What is going to happen is that once we have taken this step, that yes, the Syrian people, so the bombings happen, you are definitely at fault, you cannot come in, the Syrian people are at fault, or the Islam is in general at fault. So, once we have shown that our move is a move against this entire community, this is going to lead to mistrust in the society itself, because now this is what the French people or the community holding this French people are going to start to believe, and then this is going to lead to mistrust in the society, because people won't believe their brothers or people won't believe the next French citizen, and this is going to lead to the breakdown of society. Which are
I request the leader of opposition to come up and present. Leader of opposition, please.
Okay, so for the first time from the side of opposition, let me tell you the same things which the side of opposition told you, that what is France, what is the purpose of this quota, and how will it be seen be seen by one, the people of France, and secondly by the international community. And that is how we'll uphold the case, and that is how we'll show it to you that a very, very movement which they are saying will be against ISIS will not actually be against ISIS, right? And then they actually do not increase this quota, only then will we actually be able to fight ISIS, and that is something which will come from our arguments, right? So first of all, one thing they talk about how heterogeneous a country France is, what they don't understand is that France is a country which has been attacked twice in the last 1 year by people, by terrorists, right? And at this very point of time, I would like to make it clear that these terrorists are not Islamic people, right? You know, even the Muslims don't identify them as Islamic people. These people are terrorists, right? These people are not French, these people are not Muslim, these people are terrorists, right? And even if I am a Muslim and I am French, I would not like to identify with this person, right? If this person is existing in my country, I would not want this person to exist in my country, right? So one, when you talk about how heterogeneous a society France is, we tell you that when we talk about the heterogeneous nature of France, we don't include these terrorists. These terrorists are a common threat to all people in France, regardless of whether he's a Muslim or whether. Yes, sir. No, sir, which is exactly the point to which I'm going to come into, right? So why do we actually bring refugees in the country, right? We bring refugees because we think that we can protect their human rights better in the country than in another country, right? But what has happened, right? We were bringing in refugees, and one of the refugees actually bombed us, right? This refugee, again, was not a Muslim, was not a Syrian. He was first a terrorist, and no one wants to identify with this person, right? Even if I am a person living in France, even if I am a Muslim living in France. Now, because this person bombed France, what happens? The entire heterogeneous society that we're talking about breaks down because of these attacks, right? Because when you see that, okay, it was this one person, no one wants to identify with that person, that person is seen as a person who belongs to a community, right? And even though I as a Muslim would want to identify to him, I as a Muslim would want to believe that he is Islamic because that might be a general view, but there will be a section of society which will exist in France which will try to identify all Muslims as people who share the community with that person, right? So even, and that is the reason why I as a Muslim living in France won't want this person to enter my country, because I see him as a person who is trying to malign the religion, one, and trying to bring the heterogeneous nature of France, right? So that's there. Secondly, yes, sir.
So then all the different, given that most of the terrorists are Muslims, all the different to stopping entire Muslim nation from entering a country, right? You are okay with it, right? Not allowing Muslims.
Sort of POIs.
Let's talk about what our problem is, right? Our problem is ISIS, right? ISIS is existing in Syria, right? And when we are trying to increase the number of refugees that we allow from Syria, we are actually trying to increase the number of the potential number of terrorists that might enter, right? But secondly, what we are telling you is that even if we allow this person to enter into Syria, to enter into France, we're not actually able to uphold his human rights, because he's already been seen as a person who can potentially cause a bomb attack, right? Even though he might just be a refugee, but because there has been one example, there's a much greater chance of people of France not accept him, right? And he as a country have this responsibility towards the people of France, right? Analogy that we're trying to draw here is similar to that of animal rights, right? So we are starting, let's say that we accept that everyone has animal rights, and that in houses of society, in one of the houses, the person has been bitten by a dog, right? And nine other people say that, okay, we
want this stereotype to be strengthened in any society where people label a person as a terrorist based on country of origin or his religion.
We don't want the stereotype to be straightened, but the stereotype, the very existence of the stereotype is a reason to take the stereotype into account and to not let it get straightened, right? This stereotype gets straightened when there are more bomb attacks in France, than when more and more people come into France and are actually able to cause these attacks. And when we actually prevent these attacks from happening, people people themselves realize that okay, it's not Muslims or other people causing these attacks. It's just a bunch of terrorists, and who we are trying to fight, right? And secondly, what we are also telling you is that us bringing these terrorists into France does not in any way affect our counter-terrorism operations that are taking place in Syria. That is completely independent of whether or not there are more refugees or not, right? So what have I told you? I have told you that how will the people of France see it? The people of France will not see it in a good light, because they are already suspicious of this one person who is entering from Syria, even though he might be completely innocent. Because this person is completely innocent, and if he comes into France, he's being looked down upon by people of French, that will make him more rebellious towards France, because he'll see that okay, even in France, the entire community sees me as a potential terrorist. Even though they told me that they will give me my human rights, but every day when I go around, I am being called a terrorist, I am being called a Muslim, and this is something you don't want, right? So back to the analogy that you are drawing, that I was trying to draw, was that even though everyone believes in animals' rights, because once you have been bitten, you won't want a dog to enter your house, right? Because even though you believe that a dog has rights, but because the dog bit you, you would want the animal rights of the dog to be upheld, but not in your own house where he can possibly bite you again, right? This is the point that we are trying to make. So, and once they also come into their points about how they tell us that this is what that the ISIS will cause more bombings in other countries, and that will make other countries take less refugees. What we are telling you is that how are these bombings occurring? These bombings are occurring to these refugees, right? It's not the refugees that. Okay, summarizing the case, what have we told you? We have told you that that a person is a terrorist with respect to his reason.
I request the Deputy Prime Minister to come up and further the case from side government. Gandhi bola karta tha. Hal bhai. House building. Hostel practice maybe.
And talk about that how a person is just a terrorist and not essentially a Muslim or any other person, and this is what we also essentially want the society to believe. And that is why, Mr. Speaker, we as a side proposition want this branch to go ahead and support this mandatory refugee quota, because we do not believe in labeling of people as dogs or terrorists based on their pattern of origin or based on the reason they want to follow. They come there and talk about how essentially due to this one attack that happened in France, each and everybody seeing all these refugees and terrorists. Mr. Speaker, point A, we do not believe that would be completely true, because again there is certain sense of sympathy in the people of France towards these people, because they realize that these people are destroyed from the idea of ISIS in general. They realize the fact that all Syrians, all Muslims are not essentially terrorists. And if today France as a state would go ahead and not support this refugee quota, this would give them a reason to believe that all Syrians are terrorists, because then they would have a credibility of a state belief behind this idea that all Syrians are essentially terrorists. And Mr. Speaker, this happening just in the aftermath of these attacks further strengthens this idea that the France as a state believes that all Syrians are terrorists, which percolates on the societal level, in which each and every member of the society thinks that all Syrians are terrorists, not Muslims are terrorists, not terrorists. All Syrians are terrorists, and that is what then got that's
why. Sir, will this move be seen as anti-Islamic or anti-Syrian or anti-terroristic?
So this will be seen as anti-Islamic or anti-Syrian, not as anti-terrorist. Because again, this is labeling our country as entirely terrorist and not essentially labeling terrorists as terrorists. It is essentially saying that we fight Muslims against all Muslims because they are Muslims. Now again, moving on to the idea that now they come up here and talk about that again more attacks will happen. We can say that this is not the exclusive means for attacks to happen. 9/11 also happened, 26/11 also happened. We tell you that they tell us that a person is only a terrorist. We tell you that why does this idea or ideology of terrorism in the first place propagates because of the polarization that these certain people are able to force into the society. And this idea of polarization is at the root cause of this terrorism, especially in the case of ISIS, wherein they increase their demands to an Islamic state based on this polarization, based on these ideas in which they cajole people into believing that the entire Western world beliefs that you have. And Mr. Speaker, this polarization is what fuels such irrational beliefs in people. This polarization is what causes these people to take lives of other innocent people. And this polarization is something that France today needs to attack to eliminate this move. Mr. Speaker, we come up here and talk to you about that, how this very existence of refugees is
about point of concern.
This, the very idea of people actually wanting refugees in their country is an attempted depolarization of the society. It is an idea in which the country is propagating the message that we are welcome in our country. We believe that we are not all terrorists. We believe that there is an opportunity, there is a possibility in which communities can coexist under a peaceful framework. And this is what tackles that polarization. This is the kind of message we want to be sent out to the Syrian world, in which people believe that not everybody is against us, in which people are not essentially forced into picking up these arms and fighting against the Western world. We tell you that these moves can further be rationally exponentially increased by these people in the ISIS by making more and more people fall into the ISIS ideology by essentially this gives them a prescience to tell to the people that how the Western world is against you, how they're not even accepting you at their borders, and this is the kind of idea which we
on that point
not sir. Answer, which we do not want the ISIS to propagate, because again this is the whole idea on which these organizations operate. And if we are to go ahead and not support this refugee quota, we are giving into this idea. We are giving into the idea that coexistence is not possible. And this idea is something which we do not want. Now, further, Mr. Speaker, we tell you that this is not the exclusive cause, and as the essential themselves say that all refugees are not terrorists, Mr. Speaker, and hence we believe that again this is not taken so. And now, Mr. Speaker, coming on to essentially what effect does this have on the society of France, and what is France? Mr. Speaker, as very well characterized in our first speech and not refuted in their speech as well, France is basically an epitome of heterogeneity of society. France symbolizes heterogeneity, that it symbolizes the idea of coexistence between different societies. And that is what France believes in, Mr. Speaker. And if today this France, the French government or the state of France were to go ahead and reject these refugees from entering these countries, this would have two effects. First, on the society of France, and second, on the entire EU in general. Now, coming to the first one, what effect does it have on the people of France? As I earlier told you, this gives them a motive or it gives them credential logical backing as to label people as terrorists based on their country of origin. Because, Mr. Speaker, this is what is the only message that this group sends across is that we feel unsafe with Syrians being on our soil. We feel unsafe because we think Syrians are terrorists, and this is the kind of idea which comes into the French society if the government passes this move. This is the idea which does not really exist right now, because again, people are still sending threats towards the people. People are still to differentiate that not all Syrians are supporters of ISIS. And again, that is how we want it to be. And this is that is destroyed by this move, by us not supporting this. Now, what effect does it have on the society in terms of speaker? It furthers that mistrust in the society, even if we consider the fact that it exists to an extent. This is a move which only furthers that mistrust. And once that mistrust is not taken, sir, and once that mistrust is further into the society, what we come here and tell you is that these Muslims or Syrians or whoever these people are, who are not essentially supporting the ISIS, they basically have no other choice but to go ahead and support those organizations. Because we tell you that once this hardlining of stance of the normal French society takes into place, when this happens, what happens is that these Muslim people are essentially also led to believe that these people are racist, because again, this hardlining of which takes place, the existence of most Muslims in society is something which also becomes very questionable. They also feel threatened by such moves being passed in the society, and hence we tell you that this leads to an increase in mutual mistrust in the society, which eventually leads to a condition such as blacks and whites in the USA, which existed in the 1930s and 40s, and that is what we are very much against, given that France has always been a symbol of a heterogeneity in the society. And that is what we firmly believe. Further, France, again being the most liberal of the nations, France and Italy, this gives those Eastern European nations also a precedence in which they can also refuse this refugee quota, because now that France is refusing this refugee quota. This in turn further re-establishes the dominance of the ISIS in that region, because those people are again, the people in Syria who are not part of the ISIS, they are left helpless if these people do not essentially go ahead and support them, these Western liberal democracies or the European Union. Especially if France sets this precedence, we tell you that more countries are bound to follow in the footsteps of France, and that is what we are firmly against. So, Mr. Speaker, what we have told you is that this leads to the propagation of an idea that all Syrians are terrorists. To what extent that idea occurs is not under the ambit, that idea to be strengthened is what we tell. And Mr. Speaker, we do not want the idea to be propagated, hence, we are going to come to the post.
I request the deputy leader of opposition to come up and build up on their case.
So, the proposition has come here and trying to characterize how in this scenario France would actually go ahead and support this this quota, and because on the grounds of that, how will this be seen and how this is against the very fundamentals of France in general. And because now if you do not go ahead and let refugees in, then ISIS will go ahead and be able to convince Syrian people more that see the Western liberal societies are against you, and hence we can recruit you more and more. So I will counter that at multiple levels. A, our entire case has seen how this move will be seen as anti-terrorist and not anti-Muslims or anti-Syrians in general, ladies and gentlemen. That is what you have to understand in the scenario, that their very characterization of French people, when they come and tell me that French people are inherently rational, French people are inherently sympathetic towards Syrian people, French people in the status quo do not see every Syrian as a terrorist, do not see every Islamic as a terrorist, then in what scenario can this perspective be changed, ladies and gentlemen? So what we tell you, that this scenario will not change through some bullshit polarization. It will change when there is an actual bomb blast happening in that country, ladies and gentlemen. That is what we tell you. If those people are actually so rational, then they will not be falling for irrational stereotypes, ladies and gentlemen. They will be falling for actually seeing fear in front of them, seeing actual bomb blast being taking place, and then the news going ahead and saying that this bomb blast was caused by a Syrian refugee. That is when their mentality will change, ladies and gentlemen. Not in this scenario. In this scenario, what will they feel, ladies and gentlemen? No, sir. What will they feel in the scenario? They will feel the scenario that yes, the French government is going ahead and doing something for the safety of its own citizens, ladies and gentlemen. And yes, sir.
Sir, given that French people are sympathetic towards the Syrian rebels, won't this group by the French government refuse these refugees be seen as
it will not be seen as bad by the French people, it will not be seen by the non-Muslim French people, because they want safety of their own citizens. They know that in the status quo, they believe that not all Syrians are terrorists. They believe that yes, there might be some people who might come from Syria who might not be Syrians. They don't identify them as Syrians, they don't identify them as Muslims, they identify them as terrorists. There might be some people who might come from that region and have bomb blasts in our country, ladies and gentlemen. That is what they will see those people as. They will not see those people as Syrians. So in the status quo, if there is something, some positive existing, they are going to be destroying that positive by now. Why? When one person comes from that region and does a bomb blast, then when you say that a Syrian person from Syria did this bomb blast, then that ideology will be propagated more, ladies and gentlemen. So even in the status quo, if we don't hate Pakistanis, ladies and gentlemen, if some Pakistani person goes ahead and does a bomb blast, or animosity against Pakistan and Pakistani people in general increases, that is the reason of our animosity with Pakistan, the status quo, ladies and gentlemen. So, as the non-Muslim people identify themselves as French people first, ladies and gentlemen, and they don't identify with those terrorists as Muslims, they don't identify with those terrorists, they will not be like, okay, we are not allowing these people in, so yeah, they are not letting my brothers in, oh my god, that's so bad, ladies and gentlemen. So, this will not be seen as that scenario, ladies and gentlemen. It's a precautionary measure where they are assuring that this heterogeneity and this brotherhood is maintained, because this brotherhood will collapse only when there is a possibility of some person coming in my country and having a bomb blast, and then the animosity in the minds of people is being made. So having done with that, okay, what is the next point? No, sir. That their ideal ISIS people will be recruiting. Sir, if we know that there are terrorist organizations in Pakistan and they are training people, that we will not open our gates to Pakistani people and say all of you coming to our country, and that is not a countermeasure, ladies and gentlemen. You have to understand the fact that A, you have to first ensure the security of your own country. They are going at it, even if they might have some leverage over, say, talking shit about our country and getting more terrorists, that is not leverage enough for us to open against our country, because we can't the other countries like Germany and the other countries who actually want to take in people out of humanitarian goodwill will still fight into that, and this will be seen as more humanitarian because they're not doing it out of any mandatory obligation, ladies and gentlemen. They're doing it really out of goodwill for these Syrian people. Will now go ahead and see that, okay, even though they are not being mandated, they're still going ahead and doing something so nice. So these Western different countries are actually really, really good, are actually really, really selfless that they are doing this and not out of any mandatory obligation that has been imposed on them by the EU revision. The third thing that how will this move by farms be seen by the world in general, ladies and gentlemen? So this move will not be seen as bad by the world in general. This move will not be seen as anti-Islamic. This move will not be seen as anti-French ideal, ladies and gentlemen. Because why? Because we tell you that simply on the very basic level, the idea, the analogy that Anmol was trying to bring down, that okay, a dog bit me, and then there is this animal rights lover who's going in and say that is mandating that every house in my society has to go ahead and adopt a stray dog, ladies and gentlemen. What will happen? I will go ahead and oppose this move, then nobody will see me as unjustified because A, they know that I've been bitten by the dog, and they know I have that paranoia, so it's not wrong on my part to actually be bitten and not support. And rather, there are many other people who will now also be fearing the same thing because they know that he has been bit by a dog, so he also might be bitten by a dog, ladies and gentlemen. So then, but the other countries still cannot go ahead and oppose this, but France can. But France can because they have a justified reason to do so. So they have to be the voice for these other countries so that these other countries who are also feeling the same thing and not being able to voice their opinions in the EU, then even they get a voice in terms of a very good reason in terms of France. Yes, sir.
Sir, will now your society see that you have a paranoia against stray dogs, whether or not they might bite you or not bite you?
The society will see that we have a paranoia against bites. We have a paranoia against being bitten, ladies and gentlemen, not against stray dogs in general. That is what our entire motive is, that we have a paranoia against attacks being done in our country, ladies and gentlemen. So if we are opening the probability, if we are increasing the probability of these attacks taking place, then we are increasing the probability of people actually going ahead and being polarized in the direction against Islamics and against that is not something that we want, and that is not something that they want. And they have come and characterized French people as somebody who is rational, somebody whose ideologies will not randomly change, ladies and gentlemen, because they are inherently so rational, because they are inherently so sympathetic, then their ideologies and their beliefs about Syrian people will not randomly change. It will change only when continuously they trust in Syrians. Okay, so if I go ahead and say that I like Pakistanis, and then I see that on the news every third day, I see that some Pakistanis coming and bombing someplace, some Pakistanis coming and causing havoc in my country, then my neighbors will come and tell me that, see what these Pakistanis are doing, and you are so idiotic to go ahead and trust these Pakistanis, then what will happen? I will slowly change my ideology in that scenario, ladies and gentlemen. Such a big deterrent will come to me, ladies and gentlemen. So that is when I will change my. So on multiple levels, you completely trash their case by telling you that no, the people will be fine with it. Yes, the world will be fine with it, and everybody will be fine with it, because it is not an anti-Islamic move, it is not an anti-Syrian move. Syrians will still be seen as good, helpless people. But we don't want people coming in from their poor country, because that is only lead to our country's animosity against those people increasing if by chance for God forsaken another bomb blast takes place. So we have to reduce the probability of a bomb blast. And how much time do I have? 7 minutes. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
I invite the government whip to come up and whip the other please case apart. Please.
I think a please didn't help the situation.
I have to support my team.
Then we move on to talk about what is the aim of France when it comes to reducing terrorism, and why treating the cause is the right way of furthering that move. Further, we tell you what does mandatory refugee quota mean, what does not having it symbolize, what does having it symbolize, and what furthers the move to reducing terrorism. And lastly, we tell you how this mandatory refugee quota helps to achieve all those aims that we have talked about. First, okay, now let us consider who these people are that are actually attacking. Now, when Paris was attacked, there were 6 suicide bombers. Now, there were 6 people who were willing to give up their life in order to go against France. So, this is the extent to which people have been polarized minds of these people. And we tell you, this is how terrorism operates. This is how these communities like ISIS operate. They want this polarization in society because they use it as a tool to sway people against these Western liberal countries. ISIS is wanting this polarization in society because it needs this polarization in order to build its army, in order to sway people against these liberal countries, in order to wage war on these liberal countries, and in order to polarize them against France to such an extent that they are willing to go over there and die in order just so that a terrorist attack on France takes place. And that is why we tell you that this is the cause of terrorism, sir. And that is the cause that we are willing to treat by this move of having a refugee quota. Next we talk about why we believe that the aim of reducing terrorism should only be furthered by the means of this refugee quota and not by any other means. First, it is treating the cause and not the symptoms, right? Secondly, we tell you that it's not an exclusive cause. It's not like that refugees is the only way that France can ever suffer an act of terrorist attacks.
Sir, like
we have told you that even when there were no refugees, you had Charlie Hebdo, you had attacks which were not carried out by people that took refuge from Syria. So anyway, you cannot say that refugees are the exclusive cause of terrorism in a country. So why not treat the other exclusive cause that we have talked about, and that exclusive cause being polarizing society, and try on focusing on this cause that is not in any way an exclusive cause and won't achieve anything. Lastly, next we will also tell you about that point, the picture that they painted of refugees. They painted refugees as some people who we let run free in a country unmonitored. We just let them, we just bring them in, give them citizenship and tell them to do what the hell they want to do. They can still be monitored. Restrictions still apply to them. Refugees, they are still considered as refugees. So it's not like the moment you allow them to cross the border into a country, that's like giving you free license to bomb anything they want or anything and everything they want. So that is why we believe that the aim of reducing terrorism should be further than the move of mandatory refugee quota. Now, when it comes to mandatory refugee quota, we present to you a two-fold argument. We tell you what does not having a mandatory refugee quota mean, and how it damages a move of reducing terrorism, and what does having a mandatory refugee quota mean, and how it furthers our aim of reducing terrorism. When it comes to not having a refugee quota, all they come up here with is tell you that no refugees equals to no terrorism equals to no blast. But we tell you that specifically banning all Syrians or all Muslims from entering the country post a terrorist attack essentially reinforces, is equivalent to saying that we believe that all Syrians or all Islamic people are terrorists. Now again, they come up here and reiterate that this will be seen as a move against terrorism by the people of France and not against Islam, but that is not the case, because you are not saying that hey, all Islamic terrorists won't be allowed in the country. You are saying all Islamic refugees won't be allowed in the country, and you realize all Islamic refugees are not terrorists. So you are not allowing people who are victims of a war to enter your country. So that's not seen as an anti-terrorist move. That is seen as an anti-Islamic move. That reinforces the stereotype that we as a country believe that all Islamic people are terrorists. We as a country believe that all Syrians are terrorists. And that reinforces the stereotype in the minds of the minds of French people too.
Sir.
No. Next, we are talking a lot about how does having this mandatory refugee quota essentially furthers a move of reducing terrorism, and this is something that these guys never actually counter, that how the benefit that we are trying to bring about by this move. We tell you that the polarization that exists in the society, those people are able to sway people against us, but if we take an initiative, if we make a move, if we show some sympathy against the victims of the country, if we show some sympathy against the people, against the orphans of war, against the widows of war, which are native Syrians or Islamic people, then these people might, then this dilutes the armed force that ISIS has, this dilutes the likelihood of ISIS acquiring those forces, this dilutes the arguments that ISIS holds against us. This makes it all the more difficult for ISIS as a terrorist group to propagate all those anti-France feelings or anti-liberal feelings in those radicals. It becomes all the more difficult task for ISIS, and this is what we are trying to achieve, because that we believe is the root cause of terrorism. That we believe is something that we need to give. That is what we are trying to give the people of France. We don't just want to give them the momentary satisfaction of that they can be lived out of the grudge of not allowing citizens from entering their country. We want them to have some sort of freedom from terrorism, and we wish to achieve that by treating the very root cause of terrorism, that is the polarization of society and the anti-liberal feelings perpetrating into the society.
Sir,
please, lastly, we
projected minute.
How this is completely against all the ideologies that France has been. Religious diversity and heterogeneity. So if we as how this could not essentially be a move by France but a collective move by the entire European Union, because if we as a country, we France are not willing to accept Syrian terrorists, then there is no reason for any other country of the European Union to support this military refugee quota, and how this is all the more a great burden on us to decide whether we should be going against this anti-humanitarian move or not, because if we do this essentially, the dog example that they gave, what I am saying is that if I do not let the dogs from entering my stray dogs from entering my house, and if it reinforces the stereotypes of all stray dogs will bite you, then this will force all people to kick stray dogs out of their homes. And what this essentially forces those stray dogs, which are now only streets to live to raise a war on all those houses. And this is something that we don't want, and that is what we tell you.
I request the opposition whip to come up and thematize the debate from side opposition. I requested a lot of others.
Happened in this debate is that we have discussed about what quota is, what the quota symbolizes, and does this quota acceptance or rejection have a greater effect or greater harm when we accept it, or a greater harm when we reject it, right? And what we have told you is that the harm that we are avoiding, and that the harm we are not letting be created in the very first place by rejecting it, is something which is much, much, much greater than the random harm they are trying to portray, right? And first of all, I'm going to show you how their harm does not exist in the very first place. And secondly, then I'm going to show you that the harm we are avoiding is something which is very essential, sir. If you have two causes of terrorism, that is A, that is B, you don't say that I cannot avoid B, so let me not avoid A as well, right? I will avoid A if I can avoid A, right? That is something which is very, very essential, right? If you can avoid dogs coming into your house and you have a fear of dogs, that dog might bite your child and dog has bitten your child, you will avoid that. You will not say, oh, what if a fly comes into my house, or what if a monkey jumps over the wall and does it, right? That is not protective, but you are avoiding the dog coming in, right? Some completely irrational arguments coming from the side of that. Right? I said last minute, sir.
That's right.
The harm we need to do is essentially discussed upon three different levels, right? So first of all, they discussed upon the most important point for them, that ISIS will get strengthened, sir. Ridiculous point. Let me tell you how. Right. So ISIS is getting strengthened because we're not allowing terrorists, and ISIS was able to polarize these people when we were allowing refugees into our country, sir. So this is not something that ISIS will take into consideration, sir. ISIS is not an organization that considers sympathy to be a part of its thinking part, right? It will recruit people whether we show them sympathy or we not show them sympathy. ISIS is not a country, it has no liability, right? ISIS is just a random charging force that is irrational, sir, that is acceptably irrational. That is the very point, right? They will not see our sympathy as a very good movement, just like strong and potent people. Right? That is the very big problem in the case. And as for the Syrian people that we are concerned, right? So if the Syrian people dichotomy is existing, we want our safety first. We are doing this humanitarian task of taking in those refugees as a goodwill move towards them. It is not our prerogative to do this. Our prerogative is to ensure the safety of our citizens first and then take care of somebody else in the world, right? Me being France wants to ensure the people first. If I'm not able to ensure the safety of my own citizens, then what the hell is my prerogative to do, right? What is my burden justifiment? If I'm in IIT Delhi and if I don't become an engineer, if I didn't pick up a job, if I don't do anything, I will have a job.
Sir, how can you prove that not allowing Syrian refugees is effectively equal to never having a terrorist attack.
We are not proving that, sir, but we are saying that not allowing Syrian refugees reduces this chance of having a terrorist attack, sir. We want to reduce this chance. Why don't you understand that, random human being? We are not saying that this probability was 1 in the case we were allowing refugees. We were saying that even if this probability was 0.00001 to the power 10 to the power minus 28, we want to make that 0. That is what we are trying to achieve. We don't want that to happen, right? And the second harm that they come up and tell us, this foolish harm, that this French society, which is so tolerant, which is so secular, which is so multicultural, multidimensional, which is break down because of this one move which we are not allowing, right? First of all, they are rational people, sir, which we accept to them. Raghav comes up and speaks in his speech that we have not clashed upon that. We are not clashing upon that, sir. We are accepting that these are very tolerant, very rational people. Now, when will you have a bigger problem? As my DL also stated, when will you have a bigger problem? If you continue to have 10 certain bomb blasts that will continue happening, will you then judge the Syrian people more? Or will you judge Syrian people more just because they are trying to avoid them to not come into my country, right? That is a probability, and we are telling you for surety that if 10 terrorist attacks happen, even if that is a low probability, that will lead to a certain breakdown of the society in that case, right? I will stop trusting my neighbor if that guy is a Syrian refugee, because 10 bomb blasts have already been done by Syrian refugee. But if we stop it at this one very incident, this might be seen as by us the people as an exception, right? If India-Pakistan terrorism attacks would have only been a single thing, right? So we would have essentially accepted something like that, right? As an exception. But if Pakistan comes up and giving us terrorism attacks every 10 years, we cannot let them just enter Kashmir and feel good about it, and so that they'll stop recruiting and so that our society does not break down, right? That is what and this is essentially what the movie is trying to do, is say if you attack the Indian parliament, we are cordoning off the area, right? That does not mean that we are saying all the Delhiites are terrorists, right? That is something which we are trying to establish. We are just saving the parliament from further attacks, right? Coming forward on the third part, yes, sir.
Sir, whatever you are doing, are you not imposing the shield that the Syrian people are more likely to Syrian people are more likely to do a terrorist attack than France, than Finland.
Yes, we are ensuring that, because that has happened. That is the truth, sir. That is the fact. And that fact is already taken into the decision of the people, right? That has happened. And if another terrorist attack happens, that fact will be further strengthened, right? And we are letting that fact not be strengthened. We want that fact to not strengthen, right? What the debate has essentially become about at this point is that what I was going to come into my third level analysis was that this is irrational stereotype versus rational fear, sir. We are essentially talking about the change that will come into the society because of rational fear, and they are talking about the change that will come about in the society because of irrational stereotype. Now let me tell you why that irrational stereotype will not happen, or is a chance of not happening in our case. But if you take their case and let that happen, there is a guarantee that this rational fear will lead these people to essentially go berserk, right? They will essentially feel if another attack, even if a single more attack takes place, this will essentially happen, right? Why does USA currently hate Muslims, right? Because Muslims attacked USA once or twice, right? That is essentially what happened, right? That is where that stereotype originates. Where did the stereotype originate? If the Muslims did not go out and attack in the very first place, that stereotype would not have originated, right? This stereotype is not just because Muslims are someone who wear burqas, right? They are just against our social beliefs. We have made this stereotype on the very essential belief from the very eternity that they did an attack sometime and they continue to do it again, right? So that is what essentially is the point, sir. What they are not realizing is that their case has a proven harm, while our case has a probabilistic harm, right? Proven greater than probabilistic, hence proof QED, right? Coming forward to the next point, right? Summarizing our essential case. So what has happened is that this debate is accepted that France is very rational people, right? So what does this quota essentially symbolizes? Quota, what their symbolism was completely wrong, that we are just accepting them, everybody in, and we are giving a very good message. So they will reciprocate by taking this good message and not recruit any more people and just stop attacking us. That is something which is not going to happen, is what we have essentially proved to you, because they are an irrational organization, right? Secondly, they showed to us the harm that this great rich culture of France, the great culture of France will die down. Sir, that will not happen, and even if that happens, we are okay with that because we want to save the people first, right? We cannot just go out and let people live to wreck havoc into our country, right? That is something which we don't want, right? And on the third level, this is not going to strengthen the ISIS in any way, is what we have proven to you. Right? Because ISIS is not a thing which is just taking this reason, right? And in spite of this existing, ISIS was able to get 6 people to convince into suicide bombing, right? So doesn't it mean that they will get another reason, right? They're an irrational thing. That respect.
Do you need a common minute? Teams. Tyagi, do you need a common minute?
Stop that.
मतलब बोलते और थोड़ा हाजिर
These guys would have really shoot a chance and winning the case. We might share a good thing rather than not. So, so, the next point is, so, initially the speaker trying to explain to you that why we have effectively won this case, right? So, what these guys tried to say was that allowing refugees is equal to terrorist attacks, and hence, it's completely okay that based upon this, the entire world, the French people, the Syrians, they'll be thinking countries will be like, oh, so they're France, it's okay to do this, right? So this is their entire rationale, or something that their rationale has been. So next we tell you that what was their burden effectively, right? So the burden was to prove or rationalize the stereotyping of these Syrians, right? Not saying that we are against stereotyping, so we will counter that by stereotyping so that they don't bomb again and get stereotyped, which would be stopped if we stereotype them and block them, right? So this is something that did not, was not coherent across their speeches and would have been more sensible, or they would have been, this case would have been more stronger if they would have thought that it's just rather go out and justify stereotyping. So the next word is one, right? And once this breaks down that these terrorist attacks are not effectively related to Syrian refugees coming in, they lose out on all the other harms that we presented, right? And they never countered, even this is maybe ask Mr. Mike Shannon to please listen to our speeches when you talk, right? That humanitarian, and we are not talking about letting thousands of people from Pakistan letting come in, from Kashmir come in. We are talking about humanitarian aid and humanitarian aid to these people, which is not the same thing for letting random Pakistan people in and all the analogies that we talk about. What we talk about is the fact that this creates more direct paranoia of dogs that we talk about, and which is something that is seen in the society. We completely understand Mr. Manchin is a very, very honest person, a noble person, and his hate is only towards terrorists. But what the world sees is that his hate is towards the Muslims. And he presented the number of harms, or his hate is against the Syrians, and that is when he presented a number of harms, right? So one, when you cannot stop terrorist attacks, and given the fact five out of the six people were in fact citizens and not refugees, and only one was refugees, and I don't even ask you to take that into the debate. I still tell you that it's still important to make sure that these people do not continue hating us, right? And which is what leads to these terrorist attacks, which they did not counter. And they never even countered the humanitarian responsibility of France in itself, right? And what these actions mean and what France's responsibilities are and what shedding away from these responsibilities mean. So when they are not able to prove that there is this great harm associated to what we are trying to do, they lose out on all the other points. And when they talk about this probabilistic harm in their case, we take it that the probability of their harm increases when you increase the number of enemies of the state, right? And this is what we proved in my very first speech, and they never counted that all you're doing is increasing the enemies of the state. And then they talk about that the ISIS would stop recruiting, and ISIS would never stop recruiting, even though whatever might happen. But this is where we tell you that ISIS does not recruit because ISIS wants to recruit. ISIS gets people because people want to join ISIS as well, right? Tomorrow when no one wants to join ISIS, ISIS would seriously have a problem, and that is what we told you. And this is the way to defeat ISIS, not taking their other, not creating enemies against yourself. And then she told you about the mistrust in society and the breakdown of society, and presented to you it as a very big harm in comparison, or equal to terrorist attacks, or even worse than that, right? And which is why we tell you that this mistrust in society itself of my brother being named or labeled as a terrorist, what is that going to lead, right? My year of talk to you about it, how this is effectively equivalent to the black white situation in USA itself, right? Which is what happened there, when you cannot trust the very next person to you, you start rioting, you start creating this revolution. This is what happened in British India, this is what happened in the United States, this is what happened in South Africa, and this is what's going to happen in eventually going to happen in France, and you start this labeling and start this stereotyping, right? So what both these sides have agreed, that we should not stereotype, only just that we have said that we should not stereotype by not stereotyping, and these guys have said that we should not stereotype by stereotyping. That's what we want.
Please cross over and shake hands.